doing up?
I was already up.
Hope I didn't wake you.
No, I wanted to see you off to work.
Are those the classifieds?
Yep. Are those Pop-Tarts?
No. You know, you've been killing yourself on finding a job. Why don't you take a little time today for yourself?
I just feel bad with you going to work all day and me just sitting here playing with my silly garden.
It's a beautiful garden.
Thanks.
You hear about the old Wilson's place?
No. What about it?
It's gone.
What?
Yep. Bulldozed it to the ground a couple days ago.
Why?
It was a relic. The thing was falling down on its own anyways.
It's a beautiful old house.
And I'm sure the casino they're building in its place will be just
a casino?
Yeah. Look at it this way. It's gonna bring more money into this town and more job opportunities.
Sure.
Hey. Only good things are gonna come of it.
Okay.
Hello.
Hi.
My name is Dave. I used to live at the old Wilson's place up on the hill. As I'm sure you've heard, it was recently demolished in order to begin construction on the Eerie Slots Casino. Hello.
So, Dave, what are you doing standing outside our apartment?
All of the ghosts, ghouls, goblins, spirits, and specters have been forced to relocate to other residences in the area. I've been relocated to yours.
Us?
I don't really like that word. It's a very negative connotation to it. I prefer not to be associated with it.
So, are you saying that you're going to be living here? With us?
Technically, he's not living.
No.
The man is clearly dead.
Don't be mean.
Yes, dear. Weird.
This is a nice place you folks have here.
I gotta go to work.
You are not leaving me right now.
I'll be back later. Bye, Dave.
Goodbye, William.
Just Bill, Dave.
How's your morning going, Elizabeth?
Just Lisa. Thanks.
Oh. So what are your plans for the day, Lisa?
Probably gonna go get dressed.
Hey, guys.
Hey, honey.
Hello, Mr. Bill.
It's just Bill, Dave.
How was your day?
Eh, you know. Punch in, stuff happens, punch out.
Bad day?
Not really, just wondering if a promotion in the world of information media is really what I want to be doing.
What's information media?
So what have you guys been up to all day?
Well, Dave was just telling me the story of how he died.
It's really not very exciting. It all happened when I was mopping.
Dave, just one second. I need to speak with Bill for a moment. Bill?
Have a seat, Dave.
Okay. So, Dave needs to go.
Why?
I'm putting up with him all day.
You look like you guys were bonding in there.
I just can't stand it anymore with his moaning and groaning.
The ghost was moaning and groaning.
Not like a ghost. More like a whiny man-child.
It's always sad. I mean, what has he gotta be happy about?
Do you know what else happened?
This really is a nice garden. I used to be a pretty avid seedsman myself.
Can you not stand right there?
Am I blocking your sun?
You're transparent.
Oh. That's the aura of death and bereavement I carry with me. It's kind of a bummer.
That sucks. I'm sorry. But what would you have me do? I mean, it's not like I can trap him like a stray raccoon and throw him out of here.
No, he needs to go. Especially after I heard how he died.
What are you talking about?
Jesus. So, Dave, we can't really have a third tenant living here right now.
Technically, I'm not living
here. Yeah, I know, we've been over that. Look, at this point in our lives, we can't really afford to be haunted.
I prefer the term visited by.
I know. Look, the point is, we can't have you here, Dave. I'm sorry.
I understand. Unfortunately, I can't leave.
What?
According to the Spectral Judicial Laws and Practices Handbook, Article 1, Section 4, Paragraph 12, states that any relocated ghosts, ghouls, goblins, specters, or spirits must collect 13 separate party signatures and present them to the Secretary of the Beyond the Grave Bureaucratic Department in order to appeal to a judge and jury of their peers, who will decide if they can receive Form 1331B, which must be printed on 75% gray legally approved paper, for which you can receive the stamp of paper approval from the Dean's Bureau of Ancient Affairs. Said paper must be turned into a 666-inch
DIY.
Nice for you to come in. I didn't see you. You have a spectral ghost or other anomaly entering your home. Can't get rid of it. It's possessing your loved ones, your friends, and even your family, making them do terrible things to themselves or to others. Making you think things like, hey, she is my sister. Today in this video, we're going to explore some techniques that have been tried and tested ever since the 1690s in the time of the Jamaican earthquakes and President Williams. Stay right there.
Oh, hi! Another way of cleansing your house from sectoral admonitions
is to take a small bowl of sage and burn it in the middle of the domesticated dwelling. This will help promote positive energy, pushing out all the negative spiritual energy and or hate lust in your home.
Another method of breaking up all the negative energy and releasing the specters from your house is by ringing little bells in the corners of your home. By ringing the bells in the corner, you help break up the negativity and restore order back to the dwelling.
Sage.
Okay, so we ding at the same time?
Let's try it. On three?
So, three, here, go.
Just do it on three.
Is it gonna be one, two, three, ding, or one, two, ding?
What?
So three, here, go.
I think it's
look, four. I'm gonna count to three, and then we're gonna ding our bells, okay? One, two, God damn it.
What are you doing?
All right, Dave. I'm gonna ask one more time. But if you don't leave, I'm gonna have to get physical.
Bill, it's for vampires.
I don't know how this stuff works.
None of these are working.
I know. Why is he just standing there like that?
He's a ghost. If he tries to sit down in a chair, he'll fall right through it.
Man, that is sad.
We need to call someone.
I was thinking the same thing.
I didn't say anything.
He's here. Hi. He's right in here.
Please. Oh, yes. There's an energy in here.
Actually, he's right in there.
Well, in order to exercise a ghostly presence of this residence, we must first open the lines of communication to better understand what the ghost wants.
I think he just wants a place to live.
Ghost! If you can hear us, tell us why you're in this house.
Was that your line of communication?
Is there some special way you could ask him to leave?
It's not that simple.
Why not? He's standing right there.
Another way to communicate with spirits is with this. Please. First, we will ask the ghost its name.
We know
it's- Ghost! What is your name? First letter. D. Second letter, A. Third letter, N.
N?
Please, let me finish. Fourth letter. Jay, it's Dange.
Dange? It's not a name. It's not anything.
Oh, trust me. I've dealt with Dange before. He's nothing to be trifled with. You hear that, Dange? It's me, Father Jeremiah, your old nemesis, back to foil your plans once again.
Okay. Okay. All right. Please leave.
On the contrary, you need me. You know, I was thinking 3 sessions a week over 3 months, you know, then we'll just see how everything worked out.
No. I'm not paying any more money for someone who can't see that we have a ghost right there.
Sorry you guys had to pay for him. He was a joke.
It's okay. It's not your fault.
How is it not his fault?
Bill, don't be mean. I mean, Dave's here not on purpose. I mean, he was forced out of his home without his consent. It's really not his fault.
Well, I guess you did do a good job of getting rid of that hack fraud. I don't know, maybe we can figure out this whole living arrangement.
Oh, thanks, guys. This is gonna be great.
We'll see.